Hey guys, I just want to apologize for any audio problems you might hear during the video. My mic has kind of borked on me. I ordered a new one, so apologies if you hear any weird buzzing. Thank you very much. Enjoy the video. Hey everyone, my name's Arrayus, and welcome to the Thoughtful Free Space, putting your mind to things you may not normally think about. Today, I am bringing you another video on the biology of Alola form Pokemon. With more Pokemon Sun and Moon information, another Alola form was revealed, and we now have Alola Grimer and Alola Muk. Let's get into it. Now, first off, are my thoughts about these Pokemon. And in general, I like Alola Muk more than Alolan Grimer. It kinda has the weird, goofy teeth going on, and the yellow seems very random. I don't think it looks bad, though, and in the trailer you see the teeth are more jagged than actual teeth, which is really cool. With Alolan Muk, it has this Technicolor thing going on, it has a lot more of what we know are crystals covering its body, and it has a lot more menace. I really love it when personality gets transferred into a Pokemon. Star Trek's anyone? Hashtag Relic. Moving away from what I think about design though, let's talk about their type gain. These Pokemon have gained Alola forms, transforming from pure poison type into poison and dark type. This makes them the third dark Alola form line we have seen, the other two being the Meowth and Rattata line. Now the Pokemon website states that these Pokemon have gained an Alola form due to primarily feeding on garbage. Now that's a little weird to me, seeing as we have garbage Pokemon, Trubbish and Garbodor, and they aren't dark types, but let's try and make sense of this. First off, Trubbish and Garbodor are sentient garbage, and are a part of the poison trio we see going on with the other two members, which are the Koffing line and the Grimer line, forming a pollution group of sorts of earth, air, and sea. Grimers primarily feast on wastewater and sewage from Pryte. Now, these Pokemon have been imported from their natural habitat, and now their natural diet has also changed. They're feasting on garbage in dark alleyways and at night, so similar to Alolan Rattata, this is probably how they were able to change. Now for Alolan Muk, due to eating so much garbage and their own toxins, they were able to produce crystals that they now use to attack and fight with. These crystals are most likely cyanide, as it is one of the few common compounds in hazardous waste that is reactive. Cyanide crystals are white and irregular, very similar to the ones in Alolan Muk. And obviously these crystals are very toxic. It's interesting because these Pokemon have become even more toxic. Normal Grimer and Muk use their poison as a scent, so people would stay away from their filthy habitat. But Alolan Grimer and Muk store these toxins, especially Muk, as its whole composition has changed because of it. Seeing as it's Spook Month, imagine a silent, toxic sludge monster with jagged, crystallized poison creeping up on you. Yeah, it's not a fun thought, is it? And that is the biology on these two new Alolan Pokemon. Don't think we're done. Stay tuned for a video on both the mysteries and biology of Type Null and its new evolution, Silvery. Such a cool Pokemon. Hopefully you learned something new or think about it in a different way. If you liked it, show your love with a thumb and subscribe for more. Thank you very much. And stay awesome.